In this video, we are going to see about the chain and its accessories, which is important for linear measurement. Actually, in the case of linear measurement, there are two different methods. One is for measuring the horizontal distance, and other is to measure the height. So, using chain, it is possible to measure the distance between two points. And we are going to see what is there with the chain and what are the accessories which will be used for the chain survey. So first of all, we will see what is chain. So chain is nothing but a linear measurement device which is made of links, handles and tallies connected together to make up a chain. So chain, there are certain types of chains. We will see that definitely. So here I have given the chain, example of chain, and its components. Shortly I have shown the components whichever is available in the chain. So initially you can see that this is your handle which is able to swing in all the 360 degree, and it is connected to three number of rings, and in between the rings there is a straight length rod kind of thing, which is nothing but it is made of MS steel. So the, as a whole, if you consider from the center of the center ring to the center ring, this thing, entire thing, is called as link. And in the case of the first one, this is the link, this is the link, actually from this point to the handle, this will be the link, and this will be the shortest link available in the chain. So there will be only two shortest link, because chain has both the ends, and both the ends are connected with the handles. So and excluding that, both the handle end, other links are of normal links, and which is simply called as link. And there is a marker kind of thing which is known as tally. So these are the set of things discussed over here. In the case of chains, most probably it will be of 100 links, or it will be made of 150 links. So length of a link will depend on the length of the chain. If it is of 20 meter chain, if it is made of 100 links, then definitely 0.2 meter or 20 centimeter will be the length of a single link. And in the case of 30 meter, obviously it is going to be 0.3 meter or 30 centimeter or a single feet kind of thing. So in the case of short link also, from this center to the edge of the handle, it will be equal to the length of the link, and this is called as a link. So certainly in the case of the 30 meter link, it will be of 30 centimeters of length, this link also. So handles are made of brass metal, and it is made of a swivel joint. This is the swivel joint. It is able to swing in all the 360 degree. And there is a groove which is made in the center of the handle, which is to accommodate the arrow which is plunged into the ground. So you see a single tally, and there are about 9 tallies which are of different shapes. Actually here you see a single protrusion tally. This is the first tally from the handle, and similarly you will have the last tally similar to this thing. So exactly the same tally will be available in the last position of the chain also. So this is the closed chain. Actually if you open the chain, it will be looking like this actually. So we'll see what are the tallies available there. So location of the tallies, I have mentioned here about the location of the tallies. There are two number of single protrusion tally and two number of double protrusion tallies, and two numbers of triple protrusion tally and two numbers of tetra protrusion. Tetra protrusion, four protrusions will be there. You can see there. So there are four protrusion kind of things. And there is a no protrusion tally. You will have only a single tally. So round edge tally is known as no protrusion tally. So its position has been discussed here. So in terms of number of links, it has been discussed. So in the case of the first tally, it will be at 10, and the other second tally will be a single protrusion tally. Second tally will be at 90th position, 90th link. And similarly, the other position has been discussed over here. And there are four types of chain actually: metric chain, surveyor's chain or Gunter's chain, and engineer's chain and revenue's chain. These are the different types of chain, and this is the most commonly used chain. Metric chain is the most commonly used chain, and it is available in various length such as 5 meters, 10 meters, 20 and 30 meters. And the metric chain, the specification kind of thing and what are the requirements for the for making a chain or utilizing a chain has been discussed in this Indian Standard Code, Bureau of Indian Standards Code, IS 1492, which was introduced in the year 1970. And similarly, the other chains are there, but this is the most important kind of chain. So here you can see the entire configuration of the completely opened chain. I have shown the complete chain, and you can see here about the entire length of the chain has been discussed over here. It has 100 numbers of links over here, and it has two handles at the both edges, and it has 9 tallies. You can see the position of the various tallies, and if you count between this handle and the single tally, you can see there will be a 10 number of links. Similarly, from this tally to this tally, there will be a 10 number of links, and similar fashion it has been arranged all along the chain. So I have discussed wherever the single provision is there, I have mentioned over here, you can see, and double, two doubles are there, and two triples are there, and two tetras are there, and finally you can see a no protrusion tally or a round tally. It is at the middle of the chain. That's it. So this is the one of the accessory which we will be using in the chain surveying. The name of the equipment is ranging rod. This is not an equipment actually. This is a accessory which will support the chain surveying. So this is ranging rod, and it is available in these two configurations. So it is available in a length of 2 meter, and simultaneously it is available in the length of 3 meters also. So it will be arranged in similar fashion, and the entire specification has been discussed over here. I'm not want to go into this too much. So this is the arrow. So this is nothing but in order to mark the point in the ground, you need to have such a kind of accessories. So if you want to measure distance between two points, definitely you need to mark those points actually. So in order to mark it, you need to plunge this arrow at the points given are the points of interest in the ground. So this is the thing, and specification has been given. The length is about 40 centimeter, and diameter is about 4 mm, and it is made of a steel wire kind of thing. So it will be having a loop at the top end, and it will have a sharp edge at its bottom. So this will be used for plunging. That's it. And this is known as crosstop. This is a accessory which will be used to measure the perpendicular lines. So if you have a line, you can measure a point, or you can place a point exactly where you want in that line, and which has to be perpendicular to that particular line. So it is very easy to do. So this is another accessory which will be used, which will be very much useful. It is an alternative equipment for a crosstaff, and this is known as an optical square. So here some kind of physics is involved. Actually, this is the optical square. You can see that there is a two part. This is the horizontal separation between the two parts of cylinders. So the top part will have a mirror, and the bottom part will have a mirror. So both the mirrors are separate, and you can see the arrangement. So similar fashion will be there in the top and bottom of the barrel section. So if you see there, this is the observer, and this is the point which is at a certain distance. You can see this ranging rod. So you can see the image or mirror image of the ranging rod. So this top portion will be this ranging rod. So you will get an image over here, and this will be reflected to the glass which is available over here. This is the glass shown here, and this glass will be somewhere here, and this is a transparent or semi-transparent kind of thing. You can see the mirror image of this thing actually. So similarly, right angle to this, there is a ranging rod. You can see the mirror image of this over here. So you can see that two ranging rods, mirror images of two ranging rod has been shown here. This is the point P, and this is the point Q. So if it is arranged in a same vertical line, then we will say that this ranging rod is exactly perpendicular to the ranging rod or to this line. So this is how we will be setting the perpendicular to a already existing survey line. So these are the set of things which is very much important in the case of the chain surveying. Thank you.